Good morning. Welcome to your Monday morning yoga minutes. I'm Audra Monk and I teach at Mountain Spirit Yoga in Middletown, Maryland. And I'm so glad that you joined me today. Today we're going to do a little chair yoga because last week, well, first of all, chair yoga is great anytime. Whether you're at work or you're at home or you just need a couple minutes to move around or because you can't get up and down off the floor so easily. So a chair yoga is a good idea of a way to move. So I had knee surgery last week, and so here I am on my crutches. But we can still do some yoga because just because my knee can't do what it normally does, doesn't mean that the rest of me needs to do nothing. Soon I'll have some physical therapy for my knee, so it will be working plenty hard doing things. But I wanted to make sure that you know that a little yoga is good all the time. So I'm gonna get rid of these crutches over here. So don't laugh at me either when I have to hobble over there and turn this off because you know it's I'm timing it by myself. So I have a chair. I just have a regular chair, a kitchen chair, a folding chair. If you're sitting on, you could actually do this sitting on the edge of the bed or sitting on the couch, that kind of thing. I did this. Let me sit down first before I talk too long. So I'm gonna have a seat, nice and careful. I can reach back and hold on to my chair and come on down. I did most of this morning before I actually got out of bed. I woke up, I did a little bit laying on my bed, which if you look in the videos, either here on Facebook in videos or on our YouTube, I think I called it yoga while still in bed or before you get out. So I did a little yoga in bed, which I do almost every morning. And then I sat up on the side of the bed and I did a bunch of things there too. I didn't sleep super well last night because I think my knee is tired from what I did yesterday. And that might happen to you, whether it's an injury, whether it's a long-term thing you're dealing with, you know, some arthritis or, you know, whatever it could be. Or maybe, you know, you just need a little yoga. Maybe you feel great. If you feel great, that does not mean you can skip your yoga. You should do it too. So let's get started. This will be short and sweet. So sit on your chair and get both feet, if you can, on the floor. It's okay if you don't put as much weight in one, but you know, as best you can, we're gonna get our pelvis settled because that's the number one thing that goes wrong, I think, with a lot of us. So we're gonna rock back and we're gonna rock forward and back and forward. And then we're gonna try to find that magic place in the middle where the sits bones are sitting. That's why that we call them that a little bit, that they're sitting right on the chair. And that's gonna keep my spine upright. And right there, that, you know, that could be your yoga some days. Because if you're like me, or many people that I know, you know, some of us slouch, we lean back in the chair, it's pretty comfy, you know. Or some of us lean really forward in the chair, and it's good to find that middle ground where we can just sit up tall and the spine is happy. The belly's gonna pull in a little to support it because it knows what to do. All right, so we're sitting tall. Let's start really easy with some shoulder rolls. Oh, you know, maybe you've been at the office for a while, or maybe you did a lot. Actually, yoga is for everybody. This could be called yoga for gardening too much. That would also be a good reason you need some yoga. Roll just a little bit the other way. Just one or two. Good. And then roll them back. So if you haven't figured it out, I think yoga is for everything. And it's for everybody. All right, so then move your head around just a little. Awesome, okay. And then as best you can, find center for the head. That's the other thing. A lot of us, chin forward, chin up, chin down. Maybe we're looking at our phones. We're all guilty of it. So we're gonna put our head upright, right in the center where it should be. Ears in general are over the shoulders. Beautiful. And then, you know, maybe you're back to work or maybe you stay and do a little bit more yoga. Let's very gently bring one ear towards one shoulder. Ah, a lot of us hold our stress here. We're just gonna let it go. If things are really tight or you need to keep it extra gentle today, just do the head lean. If you're up for a little bit more, let your arm just kind of hang down by your chair. Ah, breathing. Maybe you're like, I could do a little bit more. Flex your hand and bring that arm out somewhere in the middle. Somewhere in the middle, you're gonna feel work in the bicep and work in the forearm a little too. Ah, but the neck is gonna stretch. Take one more breath here. And then if the arm is up, gently bring it down. And then put the hand back on the leg. And then very gently bring the head to center. Let's go the other way. ear towards the shoulder. And first we just pause and we breathe. Oh, nice and easy. If you'd like a little more, maybe the hand hangs down by the chair. Maybe that feels pretty good, and you flex the hand and you lift it up somewhere in the middle. Not shoulder height, not towards the chair, somewhere in the middle. And you reach through the arm. Good, the belly pulls in and we sit up nice and tall. Oh, one more breath here. Excellent, and then let the arm come on down first. And then let the hand come to the leg. And then gently bring the head back up to center. Awesome, let's roll those shoulders one time down and back. Excellent, bring the hands to the heart. Spread the fingers wide, nice and wide. Good, press the pinkies and the thumbs in and see if you can open the fingers, like a little lotus opening. Good, or you know, we gotta have a little fun with this. Bring it up in the air really high and then put your crown on your head. There you go, everybody gets to be a prince or a princess today. Good, breathe here. Press the heels of the hands in. Press the elbows back and the heart lifts. Belly is in. And then bring those hands up and out and around they go. Very nice. Bring the hands back into the heart. Interlace the fingers. Bring the knuckles forward. Now tuck the chin and breathe into the back ribs. And then let's bring those hands in, press the palms down, inhale, scoop the arms up. You see this one for me all the time. So very good for the shoulders. And let's do it three times. Up we go, and down we go. And this one, we're gonna hold it up there, relax the shoulders, press through the hands, and then very gently turn to one side or the other. Good, so the turn comes from what? It comes from the torso, from the belly, and then let the arms just float down. We're not gonna force this turn. We're not gonna ask it for too much. We're just gonna rest here in a nice, comfortable twist. All right, on your next inhale, come all the way back up with those hands. If you'd like, interlace the fingers and press the palms up one more time. Turn your other way. Squeeze the belly in gently. Turn, you're gonna find the place. It's okay if it's small, totally okay. Let your arms float on down. One hand to the front leg, one hand to the chair, or it can come to the leg. Do not force the twist. That's where we get in trouble. Keep it soft, keep it gentle. Breathe here. All right, inhale those arms, bring them back up overhead. Good, and then bring the elbows down to the shoulders. Excellent. Maybe, actually not maybe, let's widen the feet. And let's scoot up on our chair a little bit. Widen the feet, good, but still feel, and if your toes turn out, if that's comfortable in your hips, that's where you go. Still feel the feet on the floor. Good, and we're gonna turn gently, just a couple times. Good, and then come on back to center. We're gonna take a little side lean. So one hand comes down, either hand or elbow on the thigh. The arm goes over, oh, stretch out that side. Oh, especially in the morning, or in the, I don't know why I say especially, because the morning, the middle of the day, the end of the day, this is gonna feel wonderful. Oh, take one more breath here and gently bring it down. And let's go the other way. So hand or elbow to the thigh, arm comes up. Oh, such a beautiful long side reach. Stretching, giving space to the lungs, space to the ribs. Good, head looks any direction that you like. And let's bring it back. All right, we're gonna come forward. So the wide legs, remember that pelvis. So a forward fold, whether seated or standing or in a chair, is not about the low back, right? A forward fold is that hip hinge through. So sit up really tall on those sits bones. There we go. Lean forward, and you can put your hands on your thighs or your elbows on your thighs. Find the place for you. Long in the spine. So we're getting a little stretch in the low back, maybe a little in the hamstrings. We're gonna get the hamstrings better in just a moment. So don't worry if you don't feel it in the legs. Let the back be so, so very long. And take one more breath here. Excellent, and come on up. Walk those feet in. So here's the hamstrings. I'm on the edge of my chair. One leg is gently bent. One leg comes out with the foot flexed. And then remember the hip hinge we just talked about. I'm holding onto my chair here. I'm gonna lean forward, woo, and I'm gonna feel that hamstring, especially in the morning. And you could bend your knee if you need to, but if you can get that leg straighter, take it straighter. My heart is lifted, my spine is long. I am breathing and I am feeling that stretch in the back of the leg, but I'm holding firmly to my chair. I didn't put my mat out today. If you had your mat out, your chair will stay a little bit stiller, a little more safe. Or if your chair's on the carpet, good, and one more breath here. And then we're gonna come up nice and easy. Good, bend the knee. All right, other side. So this is my leg that is having a little bit of fun. So I'm gonna flex the foot, and you know, maybe on this side I don't bend forward as far. I don't lean forward, right? My heart is lifted. Oh, there we go, I've already got it. I'm holding onto the chair. Maybe I would need a little more support, and I put my elbow on this thigh. I am breathing here, letting my hamstrings stretch, giving it space so that it can lift and lower my leg and get me where I need to go. Let's take one more breath here. And then come up nice and careful. Good, all right. And then I'm gonna slide back on my chair a little bit, find somewhere in the middle. I am gonna point as I flex. I'm going to flex and point my feet. Good, because that's also really important. And I'm gonna open and close my feet. I'm gonna rock them. Good, and I'm gonna circle, lift up one and circle the ankle and circle it the other way. Oh, that feels so good. Wiggle my toes. And I'm gonna do that carefully with the other leg. I'm gonna go ahead and bring some hands in and support for this leg. And that's okay. So you make it do what you need it to do. I'm gonna circle. I'm gonna spread my toes and put that foot down. All right, slide those feet back in. Sit right back up on your chair. Double check, are you sitting forward? Are you sitting backward? Can you find those sit bones and sit up tall? Beautiful, there we go. I'm gonna pause here and breathe. Eyes opened or closed. Take just a moment. Go. Thank you so very much for joining me for a little bit of Monday morning yoga minutes. I would love for you to come visit us at the studio or let us know here in the social media world that you're appreciating our videos, that you like watching them. Thank you so very much and namaste. Okay, I gotta do the whole turn it off now.